These orange areas are the grasslands of Africa. They are important ecosystems in semi-arid areas. They are home to wildlife as well as livestock. Although animals and people migrate to cope with drought, this has become less and less possible due to human population growth, fencing and climate change. In the Greater Mara area, over 90 births per 1,000 people occur annually, which is almost three times as much as the amount for Kenya. Moreover, 66% of the population is younger than 16 years. Where Kenya has a population doubling time of 27 years, this could be somewhere between 10 and 15 years in the Mara. Also in Kenya, these semi-arid rangelands are under increased pressure. The country has lost nearly 70% of wildlife during the last 30 years. Like other African countries, landowners have organized themselves in 113 conservancies. These conservancies aim to improve livelihoods of 700,000 households by joint management of the rangelands for wildlife, livestock and tourism. Yet the communities remain vulnerable to droughts and they are uncertain about sustainable carrying capacity of the areas for livestock and wildlife. During the Maumara Serengeti Sustainable Water Initiative, a web application for wildlife and livestock management was developed by the Faculty of ITC of the University of Twente, Upande, a GIS and WebGIS company, development organization SNV, and most importantly members of the Masai Mara Wildlife Conservancies Association. In a scenario manager, users combine scenarios for grassland management with scenarios of livestock amounts to calculate the carrying capacity for conservancies. In essence, the underlying model calculates on the one hand the amount of available and accessible grass, and optionally considering its nutritious value of these grasses, and on the other hand the amount of grass consumed by wildlife and livestock. Then the web application establishes the carrying capacity as over or under consumption of the available grass. Combined with historic and real-time data of different livestock markets, users can now determine their breed selection, livestock sales, and fattening strategy. To make meaningful scenarios, users first look at historic and the next 10-day rainfall patterns and compare these to average patterns for any location. They identify periods of interest, such as historic drought periods, the current growing season, or critical livestock market demand periods, with which they want to develop then scenarios. With these scenarios, they explore how to prevent the massive impact of droughts. The web application has been built with state-of-the-art geoinformation technologies. It uses four different satellite rainfall products to compare the historic rainfall and forecasts to average rainfall. It also uses satellites to compare historic vegetation greenness and real-time observations to average greenness. Furthermore, it uses a brand new vegetation mapping method that is highly accurate and has a 23-meter resolution. It resulted from a temporal pattern analysis of 14 years of satellite data combined with 300 field samples in both wet and dry season. Also, it uses wildlife and livestock counts from regular aerial surveys by the Kenyan Department of Resource Surveys and Remote Sensing. It uses new spatial information technology for modeling with the open source ILWIS software. Whenever a user makes a scenario in the web application, an automated workflow is automatically executed on the server by the ILWIS workflow modeler. The web application can automatically extract the input and output maps and their explanations from the workflow. If the model developers need to make improvements, there is no need for a programmer to implement these improvements, thus leading to cheap improvement and upscaling. Finally, like all other technologies used, also the mobile app for people to monitor and show in real time the livestock market prices is open source technology. Given the open data and open source technologies, the costs of implementation are very limited and amount to server costs and data connections for users. And in those cases where no data connection is available, the Upande company can update standalone regular laptops with the latest satellite data stream. Both the web application and the underlying workflow have been tested and approved by managers of the conservancies in the Masai Mara in a series of 3 workshops. Next, we aim to establish a pilot project in the Masai Mara with improvement of user experience, followed by a rollout for all other conservancies of Kenya to adjust management to constraints and identify the unused resources.